Today we're at the Orlando Science Center. This 50,000 square foot science center is located in Lock Haven Park. Within the same complex, you'll find the Orlando Museum of Art, the Orlando Shakespeare Theater, the Orlando Fire Museum, and more. The Orlando Science Center welcomes more than 670,000 guests annually. Its exhibits are spread across four levels. Hi, and welcome to Aiken Adventures.
Well, we're taking you to do all the best things and all the best places all around Florida and beyond.
When you arrive, there's a parking garage located on the opposite side of the street. On the day of our visit, the parking fee was $5. Once you've paid to park, then you can exit your vehicle and cross over a sky bridge. This will take you over to the second level of the museum, where you'll be able to purchase your tickets at the front desk. The first floor was mostly under construction at the time of our arrival, but there's also a cafe there. Also on the first floor, you'll find the Cinedome, where several large screen films are shown. Most of Vivian's favorite exhibits were located on the second floor. On this floor, you'll find a place called Kids Town. Kids Town is a full-on immersive experience. Your child will have the opportunity to learn and explore. In the first exhibit, they'll learn how oranges travel from farm to table. I don't really know what they're supposed to learn here, but this is called Climb Time, and who cares, they're having a great time. Right across the hallway is Explore It and Toddler Town for children ages 0 to 2. Even Piercy can play here. Do you think he's gonna crawl soon? Seems to be motivated to go chase the balls. And he's scooting around on his belly pretty good. And when we're finished, we just toss the balls that he put in his mouth in this bin.
Now we're going to hang out in the drip drop splash section.
Raindrop is a giant water table that's supposed to teach children about the way that water moves. In Kidstown Theater, your child can star in their very own show. They can select some props and costumes over here, and then select the show right over here. In this section, your children are going to love building things and exploring. Also on the second floor is the kinetic zone, making the balls float was pretty fascinating. This exhibit is about all different kinds of energy and forces. There's balance and gravity, a table about centripetal force, electricity, and so much more. And there's a coffee shop and a gift shop. Now we're off to the third floor. On the third floor, you'll find the Hive. This is a creative space for children who are 8 and older. There are all kinds of tools in here to unleash your creativity, including an entire bank of 3D printers. This floor is also home to a permanent and traveling art exhibit. Right now, it's all sketch art that's on display. And it's on to the fourth floor now.
In this section, they can learn how to build a hovercraft.
Out these doors is the Finrock Terrace, which offers up some beautiful views of the downtown Orlando area. Presently, the doors are locked, but that's a great idea for safety purposes. This looks like an excellent venue space.
In this section, they can learn about earthquakes.
Dino Digs is also located on the fourth floor. It happened to close at 4, so we didn't get in. But there's an awesome fossil exhibit inside. The Science on the Sphere exhibit allows you to learn a lot about the universe through the projections on a giant sphere. You can do your own weather broadcast here in this studio. At this exhibit, you can use this pulley system with a giant weight to make waves. You're supposed to be able to launch a paper airplane from here, but Vivian's didn't quite make it. For more great things that you can do all around Central Florida,
click this video right here.
After you finish up at the Science Museum, be sure to stop by Chicken Guys, which is just down the street. We both got the chicken tenders with the mac and cheese.